So it's Planet Rock live backstage at Download 2015 with Mike Bordin of Faith No More.
Hello.
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 Okay, I'm not deaf. Yeah, I've definitely confirmed that. So you've not eaten, have you? You've not got your sustenance. No, I can tell.
I'm a little punchy. I'm sorry.
Yeah, gets a little hype when he doesn't get his food.
Manic, homicidal, suicidal.
Yeah.
That's another story.
So it'd be 6 years since Faith No More played Download when you got back together.
Oh, yeah.
And then I was thinking, to a lot of people, it just seems like a couple of years. But to me, it only seems a couple of years since Wembley Stadium 91 playing with Guns N' Roses. But 24 years, down come the rose-tinted spectacles.
A lot of memories.
Yeah.
Guns N' Roses at Wembley, that was fun. God, I got a terrible story.
Oh, no, please, share it. Go for it.
Ooh. I'm sorry.
You're food obsessed.
Yeah.
What I was trying to get to is 24 years. Did you think when you're on Wembley Stadium back in 1991, 24 years later, you'd be here, new album?
I mean, I don't work that way. I don't work that way. I want to play good. You know, I'd rather now.
Yeah.
Rather than that's not given. That's never given. This is what we have. And I don't want to that up now.
Yeah.
Thinking about what's in the future.
Randomly
so, you know, yeah, man, we just, yeah, whistling and sound effects.
Yeah,
it's a big part of my
it's
game.
It's a great bit of censorship right there.
Self-censorship. Yeah, not so much. I mean, you know, that time at Wembley, that was Angel Dust. So if I think back to that time, that was Faith No More putting out an album we really loved that came after an album that was commercially successful. And we're like basically standing on stage trying to ignore the people off stage who were the business people at the time saying, that record's not anything. It's not commercial. What are you doing? You're killing. You know, it's like, just can't bull the chatter. And so for me, if I think about what was going on at that time, we were trying to play music we really believed in.
Yeah.
And you know what? That hasn't really changed since today. I mean, maybe today with Soul Invictus, maybe people are more used to what we're going to give them, which is something they don't expect. So they're more open to it, maybe.
Yeah.
But it's kind of the same approach still. It's like, we give you our best, really, what our best really is. And it ain't going to be probably to your expectation.
That said, in a nutshell, you know, will there be another 18 years from now? It's not the final album and the final tour.
Never been any discussion about anything.
That was a demand, by the way, not a question. That was me telling you. That's not going to be the final album and the final tour. There's no one between us now.
What are all the kids doing now? We should do that. What's the next album going to sound like?
Don't ask me. I'm not managing you.
Nobody is.
Yeah.
That's the point.
Ah, free.
It's the headless horseman, dude. And that's a good thing. You know, I don't know. Nobody's out the door. Nobody's saying, I got this other band I'm ready to unleash. I got this or that. We're here. We're happy to be here. We're doing what we want to do. We're here because, I mean, that's really the bottom line about the record, about this, about the dates, even about 2.0. We did it because we wanted to do it.
Yeah.
And we carried on doing it because we didn't feel kind of crappy about doing it. It felt good doing it, you know? So we carried on doing it. So, you know, I don't know. I'm not looking into the... I mean, I left my crystal balls in my other pants, you know? So, you know, I don't know what's going to happen.
Well, your chef is at the door saying, you've got to eat before you go on stage. Yeah. You're going to puke. You know, you've got to have
vegetables. Don't eat vegetables before you go on stage. They digest very slowly.
All right. Noted. Well, Mike, it's been a pleasure. Enjoy the stage again.
Sorry for wasting your time.
Never.